This is how thick her hair is. Even after the hair that we lost, this is a lot. And you can see how long it even is.
Yep. First thing is, you're gonna need a good rat tail comb, okay? Now let me tell you about these combs, because I have purchased probably about 10 combs. Just go ahead and get the top grade comb. Don't get those cheap combs, because they're gonna break, especially if you're working on the type of hair that I'm working on, okay? Second of all, I have tried the flea comb. I've seen some people talk about the flea comb. Now, those break eventually too. It worked well, but it will take out more hair. So just get your regular rat tail comb, because you can use the end of the comb or you can use the tip of the comb in combination with each other to get the lockdown, okay? So the first thing you want to do, you want to make sure it's well moisturized, all right? I normally just put the conditioner in, because when you are actually pulling the hair, as you see with her hair, she hasn't been twisted in a while, so you got some hair that's connecting, and I don't want it to feel too dry, or, you know, when you're pulling it, or like it's pulling, okay? Then you're going to wet the lock. Now, if you want to go ahead and lock, do two of them at one time. That way the moisture stuff sort of soaks in for the next one. You'll be good. My family's up here laughing. They don't know how to do no YouTube video. All right. Okay. So we're going to make sure it's well. Oh, because the babies done put Vaseline all over themselves. All right. So we're going to make sure it's well moisturized. Now, remember I told you don't have to use any type of expensive conditioner. This is just regular Suave that I got. Put toward my face. Thank you. This is just a regular Suave that I got at the dollar store. Okay. You're going to need bottles and bottles of this. Okay. All right. So let me show you exactly how to do this. Now, I normally keep me a little towel, because with all this conditioner, it just gets really gooky. And I don't like a lot of gook on my hands. And I keep me like a little plastic bag to throw away the actual excess hair. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead. I'm not going to cut it for this purpose of the fact I'm showing how to take it down if you don't want to cut your hair, okay? So what you're going to do, you're going to go ahead and start at the end. You see how it's loosening up already? Judy, you're not watching to make sure it's on there. All right, you see how it's loosening up? Now, when you get to this point where it's getting a little stuck, I take my rat tail comb, I go through it, and I untangle that, and now it's able to go through, okay? I just keep on going. And then it's going to knot up a little bit again. I take my rat tail comb and I smooth it right back through. Okay. So this is a constant process that you're going to do. Now, if you can remember, she's had her hair locked for 5 years. So, you know, it's pretty in there. But you can see it coming down pretty well. And the main thing is you want to keep it moisturized. So I'm going to go ahead and spray. Put some more water to it. Now, I will tell you this. You might want to go ahead and get you a good... Turn it around. I will tell you this. You might want to go ahead and get you a good detangler. Okay? Especially if you're combing it out while you're taking the lock down. Because the conditioner will moisturize it, but it doesn't detangle it. All right? So I'm going to do that. And I'll show you how to detangle with a detangler comb once we're actually done taking down the full lock. Okay. Now you see that excess hair? That's just going to fall off. Go through it some more. All right. Okay. Okay. You can talk to her. She doesn't want to talk because she's on the video. All right, so I'm just going to work my way through this lock. And once I get to the top, I'm going to come right back to you guys and show you how I sort of break up the base of the hair. All right, keep continuing to watch. All right, so this is all that we have left. You can see all Kenya's hair up here. Kenya has been locked since she was almost 3 years old. Kenya is now 8 years old. She was just determined to get her locks down, something I did not want to do. I know a lot of people wonder, should they cut their hair off? Can it be combed out? So the answer, yes, if you're watching this video, it can be cut. It can be combed out. As you see, I'm untwisting this actual two-strand twist that I did for some of her locks. So in between me taking down her locks, because she does have C4 hair, her hair is very thick. I normally, once I take the lock down, I'll two-strand twist it to keep it from getting dry. That way we can work in sections. Okay, if you're watching this video now, this is actually taking us almost 3 months to do. It doesn't seem like it, but when you have an 8-year-old who doesn't like to sit still, she's getting way better, but when you have thick hair like this, you know, it could be a process. So really, we start off like about 200 and something locks, and it's taken anywhere from 20 to 45 minutes for each lock. As you can see, my mom's over here. She's actually combing out the lock. Normally what we recommend is that it's very hydrated. As you can see, I have conditioner here. You spray the locks. I like to let it sit and penetrate for a while. Conditioner, you want to put some conditioner in. Now mind you, you don't have to use expensive conditioner. You can use regular conditioner. And then I let it sit, and then I work my way from the bottom. Now you'll see, like at the end of her hair, she has a lot of dead ends, and that's because the hair dies as it grows, okay? So don't worry about the shedding, but if it's thin at the bottom, like for an example, she's had her hair die some few times, and you can see the lint build up in it. If you see that thin part, what I would do is I normally cut this portion of the hair, and I'll start taking the lock down from here versus here. Because once you start combing it, it's going to shed anyways. So you're just doing extra combing, which makes no sense. And then once you get it straightened or what have you, you're going to have to cut your ends anyway. So that's not going to make any sense. So she's calling the dog. Sophie, come here, Sophie. Sophie. Anyway, so I just wanted to give you a little snapshot of where we're at. And continue to watch the video. I will show you directly how to take this down step by step with the comb. She is one happy girl. Look at that smile. We started Kenya's lock journey when she was almost 3 years old. We tried in the beginning when she was one, but then she got a lot of criticism, so we took it out and restarted over. It was her daddy's idea to lock her hair because she was so tender-headed, she wouldn't even let me comb nor brush her hair, yet alone look at it. In this photo, she was almost 2 years old. You can see she had 4C hair. You know, I was worried about her looking like a boy as her locks developed, but she created friendships, not just within her family, but also friends that grew locks along with her. We shared in every moment of various hairstyles to try to make her feel important and included. She smiled through it all, and she taught little girls that having natural hair was a blessing, and we rocked our locks together. This is something that we shared with each other. I enjoyed every single moment that we were able to rock our locks together. Also, it always made her happy to be able to do other fun activities like swimming and traveling all over the world in different weather and didn't have to worry about her hair breaking. Kenya always inspired other girls about wearing their natural hair, including on her YouTube channel, Kenya's World Unlock, and various other social media platforms. She shared her lock journey along with others. The best thing that I liked about her locks is that she can wear different hairstyles, including crochets and different updos, and she definitely rocked it out. But once she became more active in the dance squad and different things in her community, she wanted her hair out. And so we let her make that decision, which took us a couple months to reassure us that she was ready. So here we go, getting ready to go into the lockdown and how we combed her hair out. I must mention, if you're looking to take out your locks or take down your child's locks, just know that this is a journey, but it is a journey well worth it to see that beautiful face smile and be able to brush through her hair without any tangles. It just makes my heart smile. Please like and subscribe to this channel and follow Kenya still on Kenya's World Unlock as she grows into her journey of having straight hair.
All right, so this is all that we have left. You can see all Kenya's hair up here. Kenya has been locked since she was almost 3 years old. Kenya is now 8 years old. She was just determined to get her locks down, something I did not want to do. I know a lot of people wonder, should they cut their hair off? Can it be combed out? So the answer, yes, if you're watching this video, it can be cut, it can be combed out. As you see, I'm untwisting this actual two-strand twist that I did for some of her locks. So in between me taking down her locks, because she does have C4 hair, her hair is very thick. I normally, once I take the lock down, I'll two-strand twist it to keep it from getting dry. That way we can work in sections. Okay, if you're watching this video now, this is actually taking us almost 3 months to do. It doesn't seem like it, but when you have an 8-year-old who doesn't like to sit still, she's getting way better, but when you have thick hair like this, you know, it could be a process. So really, we start off like about 200 and something locks, and it's taken anywhere from 20 to 45 minutes for each lock. As you can see, my mom's over here. She's actually combing out the lock. Normally what we recommend is that it's very hydrated. As you can see, I have conditioner here. You spray the locks. I like to let it sit and penetrate for a while. Conditioner, you want to put some conditioner in. Now mind you, you don't have to use expensive conditioner. You can use regular conditioner. And then I let it sit, and then I work my way from the bottom. Now you'll see, like at the end of her hair, she has a lot of dead ends, and that's because the hair dies as it grows, okay? So don't worry about the shedding, but if it's thin at the bottom, like for an example, she's had her hair die some few times, and you can see the lint build up in it. If you see that thin part, what I would do is I normally cut this portion of the hair, and I'll start taking the lock down from here versus here. Because once you start combing it, it's going to shed anyways. So you're just doing extra combing, which makes no sense. And then once you get it straightened or what have you, you're going to have to cut your ends anyway. So that's not going to make any sense. So she's calling the dog. Sophie, come here, Sophie. Sophie. Anyway, so I just wanted to give you a little snapshot of where we're at. And continue to watch the video. I will show you directly how to take this down step by step with the comb.
All right, so I'm going to show you exactly how to take down this lock step by step. Okay, first thing is you're going to need a good rat tail comb. Okay, now let me tell you about these combs, because I have purchased probably about 10 combs. Just go ahead and get the top grade comb. Don't get those cheap combs, because they're going to break, especially if you're working on the type of hair that I'm working on. Okay, Second of all, I have tried the flea comb. I've seen some people talk about the flea comb. Now, those break eventually, too. It worked well, but it will take out more hair. So just get your regular rat tail comb, because you can use the end of the comb or you can use the tip of the comb in combination with each other to get the lock down. Okay? So the first thing you want to do, you want to make sure it's well moisturized. All right? I normally just put the conditioner in, because when you are actually pulling the hair, as you see with her hair, she hasn't been twisted in a while. So you got some hair that's connecting, and I don't want it to feel too dry, or, you know, when you're pulling it, or like it's pulling. Okay. Then you're going to wet the lock. Now, if you want to go ahead and lock, do two of them at one time. That way the moisture stuff sort of soaks in for the next one. You'll be good. My family's up here laughing. They don't know how to do no YouTube video. All right. So we're gonna make sure it's well. Oh, because the babies done put Vaseline all over themselves. All right. So we're gonna make sure it's well moisturized. Now, remember, I told you don't have to use any type of expensive conditioner. This is just regular Suave that I got. Put toward my face. Thank you. This is just regular Suave that I got at the dollar store. Okay. You're gonna need bottles and bottles of this. Okay. All right, so let me show you exactly how to do this. Now, I normally keep me a little towel, because with all this conditioner, it just gets really gooky. And I don't like a lot of gook on my hands. And I keep me like a little plastic bag to throw away the actual excess hair. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead. I'm not going to cut it for this purpose of the fact I'm showing how to take it down if you don't want to cut your hair. Okay? So what you're going to do... You're going to go ahead and start at the end. You see how it's loosening up already? Judy, you're not watching to make sure it's... Hold on. All right, you see how it's loosening up? Now, when you get to this point where it's getting a little stuck, I take my rat tail comb, I go through it, and I untangle that. And now it's able to go through, okay? I just keep on going, and then it's going to knot up a little bit again. I take my rat tail comb, and I smooth it right back through, okay? So this is a constant process that you're going to do. Now, if you can remember, she's had her hair locked for 5 years. So, you know, it's pretty in there. But you can see it coming down pretty well. And the main thing, you want to keep it moisturized. So I'm going to go ahead and spray. Put some more water to it. Now, I will tell you this. You might want to go ahead and get you a good... Turn around. I will tell you this, you might want to go ahead and get you a good detangler, okay? Especially if you're combing it out while you're taking the lock down, because the conditioner will moisturize it, but it doesn't detangle it, all right? So I'm going to do that. And I'll show you how to detangle with a detangler comb once we're actually done taking down the full lock. Okay, now you see that excess hair? That's just going to fall off. Go through it some more. All right. Okay. You can talk to her. She doesn't want to talk because she's on the video. All right, so I'm just going to work my way through this lock. And once I get to the top, I'm going to come right back to you guys and show you how I sort of break up the base of the hair. All right, keep continuing to watch. All right, so we're at the base of the hair, okay? So I'm going to show you exactly how to take this down. You have to be careful because sometimes it can be knotted. As you can see here, you got flash? Dang, I ain't got no light. Okay, as you can see here, it's still combined in the lock, okay? What we're going to do is, don't worry about if she's jumping. Like I told you, she's 8 years old. I'm telling you, this, we're going through heck. If anybody tells you that this is an easy process, they're telling you a lie, okay? All right. So now I like to, when I take out my lock, I don't do it from the top. I do it from the back because it comes out easier in the back. So I flip it up. And I'm going to go ahead and comb through this a little bit. Okay. I'm not going to comb too much because once I'm done, I'm going to take my detangler comb and comb it out. All right. So we're just going to work some of those knots out. Can you put your head down a little bit? It's easier to put your head down. Okay. Now, you wanna hold on to the hair. Now, if you're not holding on to the hair, you're really hurting them. Okay, and this even feels pretty bad sometimes. But you wanna feel through if there's any knots, all right? Any tangles. So you can see like there's a web tangle. You see that web right there? You gotta break that up. You can take your fingers and you can sort of pull it softly. You gotta remember that this hair has been locked for years. So here's a web right here. Go ahead and comb it on through. Okay. So as you see, that one has some hair locked in it. See how that hair came off that comb? Okay, so what I'm gonna do now, since I have that lock all the way down, I'm gonna put some detangler on it. I already have enough conditioner in there. You want to take your wide comb. This is your detangler comb, okay? It has the big side and the small side. You're going to take it and comb it from the bottom and untangle it. Now, that's pretty untangled, so I could probably use the small part because it can get the rest of that hair that's stuck in between those webs, okay? You're going to work that thoroughly. And if you got to flip back and forward. You choking on that soda?
She done drunk all
mine. Oh, Lord, my 2-year-old. If you got to flip back and forward until it's sort of combed out, it's okay. As long as you get it out of there. Okay. My daughter's acting like she's dying. You might as well go on and cry. That's going to make your video way better. Because I told her I don't want to take this hair down. I told her. All right. And as y'all can see, she got some real thick hair. So I'm telling y'all the truth when it comes to these locks. I don't know what they're telling you on these YouTube videos, but this stuff is crucial. Okay. So as you can see, the lock is totally out. That's all done. All right, you just take a picture. Here is the before and the after. Once again, I thank you guys for watching Kenya's World on Lock. She is one happy 8-year-old.